This doesn't look like a typical beach right now. There's not a lot of sand right now because the water levels are so high. That pole is where the sand is supposed to end and the water is supposed to start. And these high levels are what led to the E. coli.
We have a purple noodle.
These sisters are ready to cool off on a hot summer day.
I like swimming. I like swimming too.
They didn't make it in the water. They came to Camp Branch Beach with their grandparents and older siblings, but the family found out the water here has elevated E. coli levels.
It's kind of concerning.
Michael Onder is visiting from Michigan and is a little disappointed he won't get to spend time at one of his favorite vacation spots.
We found this because we came down at Easter time and all the state parks were packed. We looked on Facebook and found this place, and my wife said, let's check it out. So it's a nice county park.
He loves swimming with his grandkids, but for Onder, it's better to be safe than sorry.
We're gonna go over to Little Platte Beach.
And I think we just go find a pool somewhere that's kind of nice and stuff. So it changes plans.
E. coli bacteria naturally occurs in some bodies of water. According to the CDC, most strains are harmless, but some can make you sick.
Nothing's closed. It's swim at your own risk. It's not advised.
Adults usually get over E. coli infections in about a week, according to the CDC. But for young children and older adults, E. coli exposure can lead to life-threatening kidney failure.
We were here last night. Yeah, we did get in the water. Luckily, people take showers, and that might help out a little bit. And I'd be more concerned if they drank it and took any gulps and that stuff.
A weekly test showed that the E. coli levels are almost three times as high as the maximum level for safe swimming.
I'm glad at least they're putting up signs now and they're making it known.
As the water recedes, Clay County Park Rangers say the problem should resolve itself.
There's nothing we can do. It's like I say, it's naturally occurring, so we just, time will heal it.
There's not a timeline for when this beach will be back to normal, but the water is tested every week, so the Parks Department is hoping that by this time, in a week, everything will be good to go. Alana LaFleur, Fox 4 News.